I'll go to the next one. It was funny. This episode's funny because they thought Adam ate his
doesn't keep birds
parents.
away, then there's only one other explanation for why we've never seen his parents.
Adam likes ketchup sandwiches. This is back in the fall era and like very classic time.
I love my mom's leftovers.
Anyway, I like how in this episode they make it black and white.
He appears to be doing something suspicious in the garage.
This sounds dangerous. As leader, I'll be first to go. And volunteer slips for this task.
Not cool, dude.
Don't you wish your monkey was hot like me?
The art is really nice. The visuals are stunning as always. The gags are fun.
The dude's totally naked!
Oh, let me see! He's like totally washing his clothes
in extra hot water!
What? Even the colors? Why, Adam? Why?
Obviously trying to wash.
And there's a funny scene where Adam makes a ketchup sandwich. And this aired on the new Thursday nights that they had back in 2008, like a long time ago. And I don't know, I always remember this scene where Adam needs a ketchup sandwich.
Ketchup sandwich,
And I remember the next day at school, I was sitting by my friend on the bus, and he had a PSP, and he was saying that he watched it the night it came out, like I did. And the next episode is a movie there. It was one called Animal School Musical. They're spoofing High School Musical that was out at that time. Yeah, this is another great episode in the season. Maybe the volume up. And this is really long, and there's a lot of good musical scores in it. I think you get the idea. The studio's kind of going on too long. So I'm gonna stop it here. And, so yeah, we went through human behavior. Four-eyed Jake. Where in the world are Adam's parents? The next episode is a very special boy. Or not a very special boy. Or, yeah, it is. And Adam figures out he has protective status at the school.
Not a scratch on me. Of course nothing can hurt you. You've got protected student status.
What you talking about, Jason?
This is another great episode.
Do you really
and
think
I forgot to say, in Animal School Musical, I don't know when that one came out. It was like the school year just ended. And this is like in the summer. This episode I never actually saw when it aired. I didn't see it till like 2014. And it aired in 2008. So I kind of missed out on the party there. Let me skip to the really funny moment.
Just draw that way. Carnivore of the group, I got it.
Adam has like a really high-pitched scream. And it goes on some tangent. And it shows all this real-life stuff. And I never saw this one. I regret not watching this because I remember a Cartoon Network had an event called A Whole Zoo World where the show was presumably ending. But they had more episodes going on, like at least one more special. Okay, I'm gonna stop it there. Go to the next episode. Wild Thing. This is such a good episode. Adam figures out he's the only Adam feels underappreciated because he's the only human that goes to the school, and some possum girl comes to the school.
Let's get one thing straight, possum girl. This is my school. Do you hear me? Hey.
This is probably my favorite episode of Mighty Morphin Monkey. This episode and Human Behavior tie for my favorite episodes. Whole Zoo World is really good too. But I like this episode because, like, when I was in fourth grade, like, I was teased a lot by girls, and like people would say, like, "Oh, that's his girlfriend," and like watching this is like watching my fourth grade again, and like, it's just so funny the way kids tease. I was teased like whenever there's a girl around, and like, I'm gonna skip to the end here.
Waiting in my trailer, so I decided to take some initiative myself. So, what are we doing?
Exposing Possum Girl for the fraud she really is. If she was really raised by possums, she won't jump out of the way of this feeding hog.
And then we'll run her over?
No, because she wasn't raised by possums. And now everyone will see that, and then I will once again be the only human at CDMX.
Wow, you got issues. And you're too young to drive! I can't walk!
And I also like the soundtrack on this show. Like, kind of sounds like those new Warner Brothers cartoons, like the ones, those direct-to-video movies they make with Tom and Jerry. Very nice craftsmanship here. Next favorite episode is called Lonely Lion. And it has a nice elementary school feel. Reminds me how I still always laugh with my friends. I had a friend that we'd always laugh at everything back then, and we'd get in a lot of trouble, so like, it brings back that nostalgic memory. Let me get to the gist of the episode.
And I'm replaced and join the circuit.
Some advice?
Okay, guys. You'll see right here.
I like how on the newer episodes they show the zoo exhibit that he was in more.
Well, yeah. Humans are always jumping up and down and throwing food at us, taking food.
And he tried to make Adam feel welcome at the school by trying to act more like humans. But of course it doesn't work. So, great episode. Where you review that one. I'm going to do A Whole Zoo World, which is supposed to be the last episode of the show, but they made a Thanksgiving one after, and this is probably the best one. Whole Zoo World, Wild Thing, Lonely Lion, Human Behavior, and Four Eyed Jake are the episodes I'd really, really recommend from this season.
Well, I guess you misjudged me.
Just as I suspected.
Give me those! I just didn't want to forget his face. Or his beautiful smile.
Hi, Jake!
Oh, I'm sorry, do I know you?
See, there's too many good parts in this episode that I could show, so I'm just going to show you this scene and another scene. Like, I loved, like, every second of this special. And I remember seeing the promo back in 2008, but never actually watched it. Because I missed it. I was probably playing my GameCube or something. And I was 10 years old at this time. 2008 was a great year for cartoons. Like, I was getting a lot of inspiration from the shows I watched when I was making Bubble Boy books at that time. And Gym Partner was no exception. I got a lot of inspiration from this show. And that's A Whole Zoo World. Adam became a zookeeper and chased all his friends around the zoo. And this is the final episode of My Dreams of Monkey. It was called A Thanksgiving Carol. And it aired in November 2008, and this is just the actual series finale, air date wise. The ninth season came out, they did like a chowder marathon.
As interpreted by the Charles Darwin
and the Tom Jerry marathon on Thanksgiving. And me and my brother, we were playing Mario Kart Double Dash the whole day long. I remember the day this one premiered. And also premiered the same day as Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends, Destination Imagination. And again, on this show, the artwork is very stunning, fun to look at. And me and my brother used to always talk about this scene when they go to the grocery store and they kept throwing the groceries at Jake's face. It was really funny. This episode actually aired in the nude era, not the fall era, but fall and nude era seems to be people's least favorite eras, unfortunately, but.
I never knew there was so much great food in Thanksgiving!
Well everyone, that's a wrap. That's my complete review of My Gym Partner's a Monkey Season 4. Hopefully, we'll get a show just as good as My Gym Partner's a Monkey in the near future. For now, it's not looking that way, but, you know, it's fun to look back. Like, we should be thankful that we have sites where we can watch these great old shows that they don't air anymore. And, yeah, Season 4, 2007 through 2008, great time in my childhood. And see you guys later. Bye.